गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द फिफ्थ लेक्चर इन द हाइड्रोलिक टर्बाइन सीरीज. इन द लास्ट फोर लेक्चर्स वी स्टडीड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन टू टर्बाइन्स, वाटर हाइड्रोलिक टर्बाइन्स. ओके, एंड वी सॉ द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टर्बाइन, दैट इज द इम्पल्स टर्बाइन, एंड अंडर इम्पल्स टर्बाइन वी सॉ द पेल्टन व्हील टर्बाइन. ओके, and next we saw reaction turbine, under which there are two types of turbine, Francis turbine and Kaplan turbine. Okay, we saw their working, we saw their description. Okay, and now in this lecture we are going to see the differences between the different types of turbines. Okay, so first difference we are going to see is the difference between the main types of turbine, that is the impulse turbine and the reaction turbine. Okay, we are going to see the difference between impulse turbine and reaction turbine. Okay, so these are the different points under which we can categorize impulse turbine and reaction turbine. Okay, first point is the conversion of fluid energy. Okay, now in impulse turbine all the available fluid energy is converted into kinetic energy by a nozzle. Okay, now in impulse turbine, that is the Pelton wheel turbine, water falls from a very great height, okay, through a pipe, and at the end of the pipe there is a nozzle attached, okay, out of which the water comes out in the form of the jet and strikes the buckets which are mounted on the periphery of the Pelton wheel turbine. Okay, now after the fluid leaves the nozzle at a very high speed in the form of jet, and before it strikes the bucket of the Pelton wheel, what happens is that all the available fluid energy is converted into kinetic energy. The total fluid energy is converted into kinetic energy in an impulse turbine. Okay. Now, what happens in reaction turbine is the energy of the fluid is only partly transformed into kinetic energy before it enters the runner of the turbine. Okay. Unlike the impulse turbine, what happens in reaction turbine is only a part of the fluid energy is converted into kinetic energy. In impulse turbine, the total fluid energy is converted into kinetic energy. That is the main difference. Now we'll see the second point, changes in pressure and velocity. Okay. Now in impulse turbine, the pressure remains same throughout the action of water on the runner. Okay. That means the pressure throughout the action of water on the runner is nothing but the atmospheric pressure. Why does this happen? It is because when the water comes out of the nozzle, okay, it has a very high velocity, but it is in contact with the atmosphere. Okay, and when it strikes the bucket, okay, it is in an open atmosphere. So throughout the action of water, that is until the moment when the water leaves the nozzle and it strikes the bucket, the pressure throughout is atmospheric pressure. Okay, so there is no change in pressure. Now in the case of reaction turbine, after entering the runner with an excess pressure, water undergoes changes both in velocity and pressure while passing through the runner. Okay, that means if you remember in the Francis turbine and the Kaplan turbine, okay, there was a casing, okay, spiral casing, in which in beginning the area was greater, and as we entered the area kept on decreasing. So water enters the runner with an excess pressure, that is high pressure. Okay, and when it enters the runner, it undergoes changes both in velocity and pressure. Okay, so when the water enters the runner, some amount is kinetic energy and some amount is pressure energy. Okay, that you have to remember. Now admittance of water over the wheel, third point. Water in the case of impulse turbine, water may be allowed to enter a part or whole of the wheel circumference. Okay, now what happens in the case of impulse turbine, okay, at each moment the jet is striking only a single bucket. Okay, so the jet comes in contact with only single bucket at a moment. Okay, so it is allowed to enter only a part of the wheel circumference. Okay, but in case of reaction turbine, okay, the whole runner system is filled with water. So it means water is admitted over the circumference of the wheel in case of reaction turbine. Okay, now fourth point, watertight casing. For an impulse turbine, watertight casing is required. Okay, and for reaction turbine it is not necessary. Okay, because the reaction turbine it is already under a spiral casing, so it does not require a different watertight casing. Okay, now fifth point, extent to which the water fills the wheel or turbine. Okay, now the wheel, in case of impulse turbine, the water, the wheel or the turbine does not run full and air has a free access to the buckets. Okay, as we have discussed in the third point, as water strikes only a single bucket at a single moment, the wheel turbine does not run full. Okay, and air has free access to the buckets. But in case of reaction turbine, water completely fills all the passage between the blades, and while flowing between inlet and outlet section, does work on the blades. Okay, that means the water does work on the blade only when it is fully filled. Okay, now sixth point, installation of unit. So in impulse turbine, it is water, the impulse turbine is always installed above the tail race. Okay, now tail race means where the after the jet strikes the buckets, okay, the water which has struck the bucket, it goes through the tail race and through the outlet to a water source, for example river. Okay, now in the case of impulse turbine, that the turbine is always installed above the tail race and no draft tube is used. Now draft tube we are going to study in the next lecture, coming lecture. Okay, now in case of reaction turbine, it may be installed above or below the tail race and use of draft tube is compulsorily made. Why the use of draft tube is made, we will see that in the coming